Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Tononi Conigliaro Gymnasium, home of St. Mary's basketball. Tonight it's the boys in Catholic Central League action taking on Cathedral. David Brown, the head guy for St. Mary's, Miles Lawton for Cathedral. Adams shot off the rim. Cathedral will get the first opportunity to get on the board. Long 3-point shot is up and good by Malik Frooks. We just got his name. He wasn't on the roster they gave us. Awango. Onwagu made his presence felt inside right away. St. Mary's goes full court pressure. Tipped away, stolen away. That should have been goaltending. It was up on the glass and Cathedral blocked it. Three is Jaden Reed. Five is Kaylee Moon. 22 is Dion McKinley. 33 is Stanley Pierre Lewis. And 21 is Malik Flukes. And St. Mary's lost it. Onowagu made the steal. Was out alone as he was getting ready to lay it in. It just rolled off his hand, out of play. Too strong with the shot. Blocked by Onowagu. Big time block. For St. Mary's, five is Onowagu, 11 is Badmus, three is Josh Perez, one is Jalen Echevarria, and 15 is Joseph Abadi Walsh. Shot off the mark. Cathedral comes away with it, out in front, laying it up and in. Is Dion McKinley. He went right at Onowagu, kissed it high off the glass. Cathedral goes full court pressure, and St. Mary stepped out of bounds. Echevarria trying to get around, dribbled it out of bounds, then stepped out of bounds. St. Mary's 9-0. Cathedral 1-6. This would be a very big win if Cathedral could pull it off. It's a tall order. This St. Mary's team is very good. Straight man to man by the Spartans. From dead in the corner, no good. Abadi Walsh, Echevarria out front. Off the rim and out. It went down and came back out again. And we got a timeout called by Cathedral. .507 left. We played just about 3 minutes. And we've had a total of 7 points. Cathedral's got five of them. St. Mary's has had one basket. They got that one very early by Onowagu. It's been a little bit of drought since. They missed a couple of easy chances, especially the breakaway by Echevarria around the rim and out. St. Mary's looking to stay perfect. They lost their first game of the season in the Peter Pedro first, hopefully annual Classic, but they lost to Central Catholic, who was a Division I school, and that's an exclusionary game. You designate the beginning of the season when you play the upper division teams, whether you'll count it or not. It's just a case of, especially with the Catholic Central League, to get games. They can't get a lot of games. They're a very small conference. So they need help getting games. Stolen away by Perez. He stepped right in the lane, walks in and lays it in. That was, I'm going to pass it here. And Perez said, thank you very much. He stepped out of bounds. So St. Mary's with a chance to get their first lead. Stolen away, the pass just thrown right in the hands of Frooks. Almost stolen away. I was looking, almost looks like Cathedral's playing a zone, actually a box, and playing Echeverria man-to-man. Squeeze it off, but it's no good. Anawago with the rebound. The kickoff to Echeverria. 3-point shot, no good. It hit something up over the backboard, out of play. Cathedral will get the basketball. Rosiris is coming in. Echeverria is going out. St. Mary's with that 2-2-1. Three-quarter court trap. They try to bounce it inside. Anawago catches up and knocks it out. They're looking for a Stanley Pierre Lewis underneath. Almost threw it out of bounds. Three-point shot off the rim, no good. Easy rebound for Badmus. Perez, Abadi Walsh. Dropped it inside to Badmus, missed the shot. Anawago is going to get hit. He faked, he had his back to the basket, he faked going up. They landed on his back. He was going to pass it out, so it's a non-shooting foul. 3:25 left. The offense is as cold as the weather outside, and it is pretty cold. Easily to the basket, Badmus. St. Mary's got their first lead. And Cathedral loses it out of bounds. Perez's shot, no good. The tip up. Badmus got the tip. I don't think they're going to call it a shot. He got fouled on the tip. Not a shot. So it's underneath. Two fouls in the game, both of them on Cathedral. Abadi Walsh hits the three. And Mary's trying to get a little bit of rhythm here. Four of their players have now scored. And it's been a little bit of a drought for Cathedral now. In and out. Badmus pushing it up. They catch up and they bounce it off Badmus' leg. Looked like he was going to go all the way, and good back checking by both Reed and McKinley. And they knocked it off Badmus' leg. They go to that half court trap now. blocked nicely inside by Badmus. This is Vazeris who came in for Echevarria. Looking inside, we got a foul. That's going to be the second on Stanley Pierre Lewis. And that's going to bring Anthony Berry off the bench, replacing him with his two fouls. Only the third team foul with 2 minutes left in the period. Perez to the basket. Hung, laid, and dropped in. Got the pass from Abadi Walsh going in the lane. Good strong layup. Looked like for a minute like it was going to fall out. Straight away three off the rim, no good. Pacheco, who just came in, gets the rebound. Cathedral getting one shot at the basket. Off the rim, no good. Cathedral throws it out of bounds. One tick, over a minute left. Brunson Perez, Marcus Brunson Perez is coming in for Abadi Walsh. David Brown going to his bench a couple of times. He steps off the bench, hits the three off the rim. Perez almost stole it. Anticipated that, stepped in front, got a piece, but couldn't keep it in bounds. Been a long drought for Cathedral. They led 5-2. Dadmus, kick out to Perez. Rosaris out in front. Perez could have taken it by himself, but he unselfishly gave it to Rosaris. Off the rim, no good. Dadmus forced a tough shot. Up and in by Reed. That ends a long drought. And Badmus is down holding his, looks like it's ankle. 10 seconds left in the period. An 11-2 run by St. Mary's has made it 13-7 with 10 seconds left. Ms. Gagnon, the trainer, does a terrific job for St. Mary's. They're checking on Badmus now. It looked like to be his ankle. Good to see him walking under his own steam. Onowago comes in, takes his place. St. Mary's has the basketball that can get the last shot. Rosaris hits the three just before the buzzer. St. Mary's trail 5-2. They finished the period on a 14-2 run. And they grab a lead at the end of one at St. Mary's 16, Cathedral 7 as we look to go into the second period. St. Mary's, as we get set to start the second period, Cathedral will have the basketball. James Spencer's in the game. Boy, he's like a right tackle. He is a very big boy. The difference in that first period is Cathedral getting one shot at the basket. And they're trying to get another one. Kaylee Moon went over Brunson Perez, but couldn't get a hold of it, knocked it out. So St. Mary's can get on the board first in the second period. Sammy Batista in the game for St. Mary's. And this is one of those teams for David Brown. He can go very deep off his bench and get good production. St. Mary's knocked it out. Cathedral thought it went off them. Cathedral's going back up court like, I know it went off me, but the referee said it went off St. Mary's. It's Pacheco, Batista, Josh Perez, Brunson Perez. Steps called. That's that big body. He was just trying to bang his way in against Anawago. Batista bringing it up. Wide open Pacheco. Brunson Perez faked like he was going to pass it to the corner. The defense bought it and left Pacheco wide open underneath. Nice pass by Brunson. And St. Mary's gets on the board first. Almost stolen away by Batista. Long three-point bomb. Reed comes away with the rebound. Three-point bomb by Dorsanville. And Cathedral gets into double digits. The bad news is they only have 10 points. The good news is they're only down 8. Nice pass inside. They missed a layup. Brunson Perez in and out. The rebound by Moon. Off the rim, no good. Tip, couldn't save it. Good hustle by Perez. Josh Perez will go out. Abadi Walsh is in. Drew a crowd, did Kaylee Moon. He's going to get two at the line, trying to get Cathedral a little closer. Off the rim with the first one. Gets the bounce on that one. Seven-point lead for the Spartans here. 3 minutes into this second period. Cathedral now in that zone. 1-2-2. The kick out to Batista. The rebound by Cathedral, pushing it up. And they threw it way too far. I thought if they let it go, I could have caught that. That looked like it was coming to me. Abadi Walsh with a nice little hop, skip, and a jump. And the lead is 9, 20-11. They double up at half court, and they're gonna pick up a foul. Only the second team foul on St. Mary's. And it's the second foul on Pacheco. Henry Maraca. Wide open, nice pass from Danville to Moon for the easy layup. Josh Perez is back, Brunson Perez goes out. Batista will bring it up. Looking to go inside. Tipped away by Cathedral. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Tipped and knocked away. Almost stolen away by Reed. Now that I thought it went off Reed, they're saying that St. Mary's tipped it. Cathedral gets the basketball. They can get a little closer. Shot clock winding down. Up and good by Dorsainville. He's got 5 coming off the bench in this period, and the lead is down to 5. Cathedral hanging back, trying to block inside, telling St. Mary's, you're going to beat us, you're going to beat us from outside. Avadi Walsh will say, okay, I'll take it. His second trifecta. And the lead is back to 8. They get it right back to Sandville. He's got 8 points in this period, his second trifecta. He answers Avadi Walsh's trifecta. The lead is back to 5. Avadi Walsh gets swallowed up. We got a block. Strong drive to the basket by Maraca. His shot was way over everything, out of play. But he got hit on the way to the basket, and he'll get 2 at the line. Third foul on Stanley Pierre Lewis. Only the 8th point in the period for St. Mary's. Missed that one. Cathedral tracks it down. Nice pass inside. Moon gets the layup. He's got 5 in the period. And the net, big lead for St. Mary's, is down to 4 with 2 minutes left in the period. Foul before the shot. St. Mary's will be shooting the free throws the last minute 56. As Cathedral has reached the limit. It went out off Perez. Cathedral can get a lot closer. Batmus is saying, I think I got hit, but they didn't call it. Cathedral's hanging around. They saved it, but right to Badmus. They had a chance to close the gap, and they threw it out of play. They try to go inside to Badmus and they throw it away. And now Badmus getting a little bit of to do. A little pushing and shoving with Anthony Berry. And they, Coach Lawton saw that and he said, we don't need that. He takes Berry out of the game. St. Mary's jacks it up to full court. And they threw it too high off the fingertips of Frooks. Right into the student body, St. Mary's. 1:18 left, St. Mary's by two. They need a basket to get double digits in this second period. They only got 8 points. But they still lead by four. Nice pass. Again, Pacheco inside. Great pass by Josh Perez. Faked the pass one way. They bit underneath. And Pacheco, that's the second time he's hit Pacheco wide open underneath. And he's looking for a conventional three-point play. And we mention each and every time, Pacheco, outstanding three-sport athlete. Shortstop pitcher in baseball. Very good defensive as well as receiver in football. And obviously basketball. Missed the shot inside and he got knocked out by Cathedral. Lawton saying, how come we're not getting a foul call? 45 seconds left. St. Mary's could kill most of the game clock. The kick out, the shot, in and out. The rebound hung and didn't go in. Morocco made a great play, got underneath, under the basket, trying to spin it in. And now Batista took it away. Easy layup for Badmus. Everybody going down. And St. Mary's player is still down. He's getting helped up. Josh Lopez was holding his leg for a minute, but he got up, says he's okay. So St. Mary's, Cathedral had a shot. They were down four. They had the ball a couple of times. But St. Mary's got the last 4 points, and St. Mary's holding on. They only got 12 points in the second period, but it's enough for an eight-point lead. It's 28-20, St. Mary's over Cathedral at halftime. St. Mary's will have the basketball as we start the second half. Joseph Abadi Walsh had 8 to lead St. Mary's. Josh Perez, Dadmus, and Lee Pacheco each had 4 apiece. On the other side, Kyle Dorsainville had 8, all coming in the second period. Kaylee Moon had 5, all coming in the second period. St. Mary's trailed 5-2 early on. They went on a 14-2 run. Open up a 16-7 lead at the end of one. They wound up with only 12 points in the second period, but Cathedral only got 13. So they held on to the 8-point lead after leading by 9 at the end of one. Cathedral had it down to 4, and they had the basketball a couple of times. Shot, no good. Tip up and in by Abadi Walsh. He's got double digits. St. Mary's goes at three-quarter trap. Perez tips it away. Can't hit the shot. Abadi Walsh again over everybody. Tipped another one in. They handed the ball to Cathedral to take out, and the young man taking it inbounds. Off the rim, no good. Step inbounds that cost him the turnover. the runner, no good. The body Walsh tipped it. Cathedral comes out with it. Nice pass underneath to Reed. Very nice pass from Berry. Abadi Walsh comes out on fire. Seven straight points. And the lead is the most it's been, 13 points. They almost lost it out of bounds. Shot no good. Knocked out by Cathedral. Abadi Walsh with two big tip-ins and a three-point basket. And all of a sudden, that lead a while ago in the first half that was 24-20 is now 35-22. Echeverria lost it. Getting it back on Owagu, lulled all around the rim. Two near misses, but they were misses. Tipped away, and then tipped away again. 12 seconds on the shot clock. I don't think they realize the shot clock is winding down. They got to get it up. The bench is sitting right there. They're right in front of their bench, the players and coaches, and nobody told them, throw the ball up because the shot clock is winding down. So it's an error on the players out in the court, but it's an error also on the coach and the staff and the players on the bench not yelling to whoever had the basketball, he'd throw it up. Went right through the wickets, but they get it back. They call it a three by Brooms. His second trifecta. Cathedral gets it back. They can get it under double digits. And Sabria is going to get called for the foul. Reaching for the ball, all he got was the arm of Jaden Reed. Nice pass inside, they missed the layup. And it got knocked out by Cathedral. Coach Miles Lawton has been up the entire game having a very long discussion with both officials. Abadi Walsh misses the shot. Nice box out, good rebound by Stanley Pierre Lewis. They try to go inside and they threw it away. Pacheco was coming in, Abadi Walsh is coming out. St. Mary's has 7 points in the first 4 minutes. Abadi Walsh has got all of them. Nice move to the basket, but it won't go. Looks like there's a lid on the St. Mary's basket. Three-point shot by DeSaneville. He came in the second period and got eight. Two trifectas, that's his third. He gave him a little bit of a boost. The lead now is down to 7. It was 13. Perez hits the fall away. He's the first one to score in the period, otherwise, other than Abadi Walsh. They got the foul on Badmus. Pacheco almost picked it off. Long three-point bomb by Brooms, his third. And the lead is down to 6. Cathedral refuses to go away. Badmus can't hit it. Gets his own follow, can't hit it. It's taken away. 2 tries, Moon just ripped it away. Three-point basket by Dorsainville, his fourth. And the lead is 3. It was just 13. Stolen away, but he couldn't keep it in bounds. Brunson Perez is in for Josh Perez. Nice pass. Pacheco gets hit. Great look by Badmus. He drew a double team. He saw Pacheco breaking. Hit him with the perfect pass. Good heads up by Pacheco to go to the basket for the layup. And they can get the lead back up to 6. Big three-point baskets by Brooms and Dorsainville. Got it down to 3, and now the conventional 3 by Pacheco gets it back up to 6. It was 35-22, a 12-2 run by Cathedral. The runner won't go, but he got fouled. Brooms will go to the line for 2. He threw up a prayer. It wasn't answered, but it can answer with the foul. Third foul on Pacheco. Abadi Walsh is coming back. Around the rim and out. Pacheco's going out with his 3 fouls. Brooms makes 1. Two minutes left in this third period. St. Mary's by 5. Shot no good. Tough pass to make. Onowago saw it coming, but half a step late, he got a hand on it, knocked it into the Cathedral bench area. So they can get close again. They could get another 3. They would cut the lead to 2. St. Mary's coming out on the shooters. Drive no good. Rebound inside, block. Cathedral gets it back. In and out, what a basket that would have been. Shot no good. They try to go up court. Echeverria lays it in, that's his first basket. under a minute. St. Mary's by 7. Tough shot by Brooms, but not a good shot to take. But before he took it, Coach Lawton called a timeout, so Cathedral still have the basketball. St. Mary, it's been a game of runs. They had a 14-2 run to end the first period. They go up by 9. They had an 11-2 run. It was 24-20 late in the second period. Into the third period, the 11-2 run made it 35-22, the biggest lead of St. Mary's, 13. And then Cathedral went on a 12-2 run to get back within 3, 37-34. St. Mary's has answered with a 5-1 run. And that's where we are, 7-point lead with 51 seconds left. Cathedral, he must have played some very good teams. They don't look like a 1-6 team. They're giving St. Mary's all they can handle. And we're going to get a foul against Cathedral. I don't know if it was a foul or a flop. Prince and Perez wound up on the floor, and they called a foul against Stanley Pierre Lewis, and that's his fourth, so he has to come out. Three-point basket by Echevarria. Back to a double-digit lead, 10, and now backcourt. They threw it ahead to McKinley. He threw it back to Brooms. Brooms then getting the front court. So St. Mary's can take the last shot if they choose. We got a whistle, and we got Badmus and Berry went at it before. And now they step in front. Way back in the first half, they went at it, and the coach Lawton took Berry out. And they call a foul on Cathedral. There's a sizable difference between Badmus and Berry. But Berry not backing down. And they just got Berry again. Out to Abadi Walsh. They can hold for one. Echevarria gets knocked down as he goes to the basket. He didn't have a point in the first half. He doesn't miss very often, but he missed that one. He's not having his best shooting night. Onowago goes out. Josh Perez is in. Missed them both. I'm glad I was here to see it. I haven't seen him miss two free throws, I think, for the year. Clock is winding down. He just threw it up, and that's going to do it. So a 12-2 run by Cathedral got them back within 37-34. St. Mary's goes on an 8-1 run to end the third period. That gets it back up to double digits. So at the end of 3, it's St. Mary's 45, Cathedral 35. Cathedral have the basketball. St. Mary's has a 10-point lead. We've been here before. The foul will be on Echevarria. Blocked by Badmus. Out off Badmus. Cathedral got stuck. They get rid of it. They did it again. They didn't, yet. Right in front of their own bench. Nobody told them to throw the ball up. They held on to it for a long time. They finally yelled with 2 seconds left, shoot it. And he had to fire it in a crowd, hit nothing. That's twice that they haven't helped their teammates. Foul, Brunson Perez, faked the three, went by to Dorsainville, and then got bumped. Badmus having all kinds of problems inside. They got James Spencer covering it now, and Spencer is about the same size and the same weight. So that's a match that doesn't favor Badmus. Inside to Badmus, and he lays it in and he says something to him going up. No good. Echevarria. Cathedral wants a timeout. Biggest lead of the game for St. Mary's, 14. And a little not happy feelings between the two teams. Both coaches going at the official. That 8-1 run has extended to 12-1 here in the fourth period, opening up a 14-point lead, the biggest lead of the game for the Spartans. And these two teams don't like each other. A little extracurricular activity. They have to play them again at Cathedral. Badmus trying to talk to two officials. They said, go sit down. Badmus was having his way a little bit inside, but they brought in James Spencer, and he's like a right tackle and a right guard. He's a big boy. And he matched up very well with Badmus, although Badmus beat him with that layup. It wasn't easy. Now they go over the top to try to get the ball up court, and they throw it away. Rosieris is in the game. Perez right down the lane, kicks it out. Abadi Walsh, off the rim, no good. Anawago comes away with the rebound. Abadi Walsh in the lane. The layup goes. Shot won't go, but Moon's strong drive is going to go to the basket. This could end a very long drought. Henry Maraca is back in the game for the Spartans. Just under 6 minutes left in this one. And Maraca throws in a three coming off the bench. Inside, we didn't get a tie-up, we got a foul. Both teams will be shooting free throws the rest of the way. Both teams have reached the maximum. Bodies go down in the lane. There's two bodies down. It's going against St. Mary's. That's going to be 1-1 for Spencer. I think they're going to take Spencer out, but he's at the line. They can't. He needs the first to get the bonus. Off the rim, no good. Loose. Rosaris gets the loose ball. Echeverria too strong. That was a very quick three. Up and good. That's a long time coming, that basket. Short, no good. Anawagu. Inside Anawagu, nice pass. ...18-point lead for the Spartans. Abadi Wall steals it. Block, he gets it back. It deflected. Rosiris kept it in play. We got a jump ball, it'll be St. Mary's basketball. They made a 12-2 run to make it 37-34. They've got one basket. And a couple of free throws. Off the foot, stolen away, but it goes out of bounds. The back official is going to get together and make the right call because it went off Cathedral. No question it went off Cathedral. I don't know how they could even argue that. Moon wound up out of bounds, almost had the ball with him. But Tista in the ball game. They kick it out to Maraca. A three-point basket, his second. Stolen away. Abadi Walsh. Onawagu. St. Mary's running away with it now. Moon, who's played well, gets inside and lays it in. Only the second basket. Echeverria. Steps called it. Moon got a running start. Shot missed. Deflected away by Echeverria. 2:36 left. He draws the contact on Onowago. Moon was playing well inside. No good. He had five in the second period. He's got five here in the fourth period. Echeverria got bumped, he fell down, he wound up out of bounds. And the crowning point is they're giving the ball to Cathedral. Two minutes and counting left. Inside the Moon again. He gets fouled again. Fourth foul on Onowago. Moon's found a home inside. Both teams are shooting free throws. Cathedral will shoot two the rest of the way. Shot not close, missed everything. Missed. Blocked out by Pacheco. Cathedral got 7 points in the first period. They got six here in the fourth period. St. Mary's has put this one in the bank, obviously. Tip loose. Wide open at Echeverria. He had zero in the first half. He's got 11. Shot no good. Three St. Mary's shirts battling for the rebound, and it goes out of bounds off all three of them. 1:34 left. Almost another three-point shot to Shaneville. Batista got stuck, threw it back. There was nobody there, but Echeverria and Onowago saved it. In and out with the three-point shot. A minute and counting. St. Mary's going to go to 10-0 with Onowago all the way down. Batista all by himself lays it in. Short, no good. Anawago with the rebound. Pacheco with the layup. To 41, they finally put Cathedral away. Their biggest period of the day, 24 points. Cathedral went on a 12-2 run to cut it to 37-34 in the third period. St. Mary's ended it with an 8-1 run to get it to double digits. They increased it to 17-2 to push it to 18. And now the run is now 32-7 since it was 37-34. And it's now a 28-point lead with the clock winding down. I don't know if they're running the clock out or not. They just threw the ball away, it went out of bounds. So Cathedral's gonna wind up with 41 points. St. Mary's will hold on to it, and that's gonna do it. So St. Mary's will go to 10-0 as the buzzer sounds. It's going to look like a blowout, 28 points, but it was a game in the third period at 37-34. But then St. Mary's finishes the game 32-7. 6 points in the fourth period for Cathedral, 7 in the first. That's 13 points in two periods. They matched that in the second period with 13, and St. Mary's ends finally gets it going, and they blow them away, 69-41, with a big 24-point fourth period after Cathedral kept coming back, cutting it down. They had it to 13, they cut it to 4. They built it back up to 10 at the end of 3, and that final run, 32-7, over the last period and a half, puts the game away, 69-41 in favor of St. Mary's. For Cathedral, Moon played very well. He had 10. Tosainville gave him a little bit of push in the middle periods, getting 14 with 4 3-point baskets. For St. Mary's, Pacheco had a nice game at 9. Maraca came off the bench with 2 big 3s, getting 7. Batista had 2. Badmus had 6. Onawagu had 6. Josh Perez had 6. Marvin Roseros had 5. Echeverria got it going after sitting most of the first half. He got 11 in the second half, and Abadi Walsh got him going in the third period with 7 consecutive points. He winds up as the leading scorer with 17 points in the game. And St. Mary's will continue undefeated, stay undefeated in the league. They go to 10-0. Cathedral will drop to 1-7, but they're gonna win some games. They got some pretty good players. So the final score, St. Mary's 69, Cathedral 41, with that 32-7 run from the midway point of the third period till the end of the game, holding up to 6 points in the fourth period. So 69-41, St. Mary's over Cathedral. We hope you enjoyed it. I'm John Hoffman saying we'll see you next time.